is a fact. If you make stuff, fix stuff, clean stuff, or paint stuff, you'll have waste you need to deal with. Some waste is dangerous and must be handled safely to protect human health and the environment. Even small quantities of dangerous waste can be harmful. Knowing whether or not your waste is dangerous and knowing how much of it you generate will help you determine your generator status and what rules apply. Your business can be a small, medium, or large quantity generator of dangerous waste. In this case, bigger is not better. It is very beneficial for businesses to have small quantity generator, or SQG, status. Small quantity generators of dangerous waste have far fewer regulations to follow and fewer hoops to jump through to be compliant.
So just to frame it a little bit, a small quantity generator of hazardous waste essentially only generates a very small amount of waste. It doesn't necessarily mean, you know, it's a small business. Okay, it could be a really big business, but they only generate a small amount of hazardous waste.
I'm Jeff. I work at Kitsap Transit. I'm the vehicle and facilities maintenance manager. We service the whole Kitsap County. We have approximately 450 pieces of equipment, and we are a small quantity generator of hazardous waste.
The advantages to being an SQG are predominantly less regulation.
There's less paperwork involved.
You wouldn't have to register with Ecology as an SQG, as a small quantity generator.
Less record keeping.
In essence, you're free to operate without very much supervision at all.
So how do you know if you're a small quantity generator? It depends. It all depends on how much dangerous waste you generate each month and keep on site. For instance, for most types of dangerous waste, if you generate less than 220 pounds a month, you qualify as a small quantity generator. On average, this is what 220 pounds of dangerous waste looks like, half of a 55-gallon drum of liquid waste. There are other, even more hazardous wastes that are considerably more restrictive. Those that designate with a P code, WTO1 toxics, and a few F-coded wastes. You need to generate less than 2.2 pounds of this nasty stuff, roughly a quart, to qualify as an SQG. In addition, a small quantity generator can never amass 2,200 pounds or more of dangerous waste on their premises at any given time. So you need to have a plan with a hazardous waste service provider or properly transport the waste to an appropriate facility yourself to keep from accumulating 2,200 pounds or more of dangerous waste. Becoming a small quantity generator is possible, even for many larger businesses. Many different types of businesses can be SQGs, some of them surprising. Machine shops, boat yards, retail big box stores, metal fabricators, nail salons, veterinary clinics, all of these are common SQG businesses. It all depends on how much dangerous waste you generate each month and keep on site.
So a small quantity generator, again, only generates a small amount of waste. They only have three things they have to do under our rule. You have to designate the waste, which means you have to take a good look at the waste and see if it's hazardous.
Designation is the process of determining whether or not that waste is a dangerous waste here in Washington.
Second thing you got to do is, while you're accumulating it on site, you have to safely manage it. You know, you don't want employees to get hurt or the environment.
Safely handling waste means making sure that waste containers are in good condition, out of the weather, and off the ground, and closed. The containers need to be clearly labeled to make sure that your employees and anyone else who comes in contact with the waste knows what it is and the risks associated with it.
We encourage things such as secondary containment for dangerous waste to alleviate spills, leaks and drips into things like storm water.
What we're coming up on here is our storage containers. They have secondary containment down at the bottom, so there's no chance of it getting into the environment.
Make sure that you're storing waste that are compatible with each other. You don't want to have reactive waste right next to ignitable waste, for example.
You want to be cognizant of making sure the containers you're storing these materials in are compatible with their contents.
And then the third thing is you need to properly dispose of it.
you can contact a reputable hazardous waste service provider to transport your waste for disposal, or you can transport it yourself to a proper receiving facility.
In Washington, we have a lot of collection centers for, you know, small quantity generators. Each county is a little bit different. They can either contact somebody at ecology or contact their local environmental services or health department to find out what the options are for small quantity generator waste disposal. You know, those are the three things that are required. A really great idea is to keep records of the proper disposal, you know, so that you can show that you've been safely managing your waste off-site. I really recommend that people, while they're accumulating stuff on-site, that they have all of the containers labeled, and that they, you know, keep proper spill controls in place, that they train their workers, that they keep records of employee training. And then they also keep a record that they've walked through the designation process to figure out if something is hazardous. So those are recommendations, and I think in the long run they give you a lot less liability.
Hi, I'm Dr. Chelsea Newby. I work at Loyal Family Veterinary Practice in Bellevue, Washington, and we're a new clinic. We have two doctors here, myself and Dr. Rebecca Rogers. When we decided to become certified with the EnviroStars, we felt that as a new business, we really wanted to be as environmentally sound as possible. As a side benefit that we got from that, we're able to post our business as being EnviroStar certified, which we're very proud of. And they also actually helped pay for part of our digital X-ray machine. First of all, it's just a lot more convenient. You don't have to be processing the film, but also reduce the silver waste that really should be kept out of the environment. The other nice thing is that there are a lot of nearby businesses that will recycle electronic waste, which we haven't really had a lot of, but if we do have computer cords or ink cartridges, even batteries, that kind of thing, we can take those to certain facilities and they will recycle it.
Have you ever heard of that World War II slogan, use it up, wear it out, use it over, or do without? That slogan still applies. So when I'm out working with a business, doing an inspection or a technical assistance visit, those are the four things I'm constantly looking at. You know, how can we use it over? How can we do without this particular chemical?
Maybe there's something less toxic, less dangerous, that you could use instead of what you're using, so that when you do create a waste, it's not a dangerous waste.
Right over here, we have two parts washers that uses hot water and a soap mixture. These replaced our solvent tanks that we had years ago. And when we had the solvent tanks, we generated all that solvent waste, 75 gallons of solvent that would last a month, two, that we're not generating.
Ultimately, what we want to do is try to get folks to reduce what they're using or recycle what they are generating.
Now, here are some good news. Certain wastes are excluded or exempt when counting for your SQG status. The most common exemptions are universal wastes like fluorescent bulbs and batteries, used oil that's recycled or re-refined, spent antifreeze that's being recycled, or e-waste.
There are certain wastes that are everywhere. So one of those is used oil. And the cool thing is that it can be reclaimed and reused. So what we wanted to do is give businesses an opportunity to safely accumulate that stuff and then get it to a place that can reclaim it.
About 15 years ago, we bought this light bulb crusher. It's for crushing fluorescent tubes. At the time, it was state of the art. As time goes on, we found out that after you crush it, it's now classified as hazardous waste. So to avoid having hazardous waste here, we decided to go with the vendor's package, where he brings containers that we store our used fluorescent bulbs in. Then we seal them up, call him, he picks them up, and he takes them to their site, and they recycle them.
Trying to move from generating a lot of hazardous waste to just a very little bit is, it just makes good sense. You save money. You are investing in your employees by having a safer workplace. You're investing in your local environment.
So what if you exceed the limits to be a small quantity generator? Well, then you'll be a medium or large quantity generator. And in that case, you'll have a heck of a lot more hoops to jump through. There'll be more regulations, paperwork, and possibly fees. It's just more complicated. You might want to think about how to get small. That is not what I meant.
We work with a lot of different types of generators, from small all the way to large quantity generators. What we like to do is try to move people from the large down to the small quantity generator, because then we know we've got a lot less waste that has to be dealt with that could potentially end up in our environment.
There are people who can help you get small and stay small, or eliminate your dangerous waste altogether. Resources may differ depending on where you live.
So some strategies that are available are just communicating with your local public works or health district, since they tend to govern waste in most jurisdictions. The public health department fosters a program in Kitsap County for the Department of Ecology called Local Source Control. And in that particular facet of dangerous waste, we have a specialist meeting with businesses, particularly small quantity generator businesses, to speak with them on a one-to-one level about pollution prevention.
And then we also, at the Department of Ecology, we have a toxics reduction group. And they're looking at greener chemistries. They provide technical assistance. They'll go out with different gadgets and measure energy loss. They'll measure flow. And they'll engineer systems that'll help you reduce the amount of waste that you're generating. So there are lots of options. There's also tons of information online about different alternatives.
I think most businesses out there could qualify as an SQG. I think most businesses generate universal waste, fluorescent tubes, batteries. Those are easily recyclable.
Any type of business can be an SQG. It can be, a lot of times the misconception is that an SQG is a small business.
You know, as an example, you know, a company I was at not that long ago, they make that cement board siding, and they make tons of it. I mean, they're one of the biggest distributors in the States. And they switched to a water-based solvent, and so now they're generating a lot of wash water that they clean up and reuse, and they're no longer generating hazardous waste. So they went from being a large quantity generator to boom, just by making that one product change to being a small quantity generator.
And again, becoming a small quantity generator of dangerous waste offers huge benefits for you and your business. Yes, you're exempt from a lot of regulations, but don't forget that you're still required to designate your waste, handle and store your waste safely, and recycle or dispose of your waste properly. It is also advisable, not required, but a darn good idea, to regularly dispose of your waste to avoid accumulating more than the SQG limit, keep records to verify that you are indeed an SQG, and manage your waste following best management practices.
I'm Scott Knox from Point Defiance Marina. We're a facility of Metro Parks Tacoma. We have a beautiful facility here. I've been here for many years. We've been putting people on the water for over 100 years. One of the things we feel like at this facility is that it's not good enough just to be a clean, green marina. We have to teach clean and green through our programming, events, and classes. The benefits of being a small quantity generator are several fold. One is for our staff. It keeps them safe and happy. The customers also see it on a day-to-day basis. The environment itself benefits. And just as importantly for me as a supervisor, the bottom line benefits, because we're not having to spend extra money on those kinds of programs.
Take strides to reduce or eliminate the dangerous waste you generate. Be smart about it. Decrease pollution, reduce and recycle waste, choose safer alternatives. Being a small quantity generator can work for your business, your employees, and the environment. It's the next best thing to having no dangerous waste at all.